Welcome to Warn. Today's news is: First Indigenous Advanced Lightweight Anti-Submarine Torpedo of India. The Advanced Light Torpedo, TAL, Shyena is the first indigenous advanced lightweight anti-submarine torpedo of India, developed by Naval Science and Technological Laboratory of the DRDO for the Indian Navy. Shyena is a processor-based torpedo which incorporates solid-state electronics, digital technology and has been equipped with an integrated active/passive sensor package for homing. It is designed to be capable of launching from both a helicopter or from a triple-tube launcher on surface vessels. Its key design feature are maneuverability and ability to transition from warm to cold medium to ensure a hunt and kill. The development period of the torpedo was quite long, starting in the 1990s, and was inducted into the Indian Navy on March 3, 2012, when the Indian Defence Minister A.K. Antony handed over the first consignment of TAL to the Navy in Hyderabad in March 3. Shyena was to be an improved A244S but apparently was that in name only and not as capable as the latest MK3 version of the A244S, which has a longer range, 13.5 km compared to 6 km, and a much more effective sensor and guidance system. In 2012, after 2 decades of development, India put Shyena into production and at least 25 were delivered to the Indian Navy for use on helicopters. In early 2017, Burma ordered $40 million worth of the new Indian-made Shyena lightweight anti-submarine torpedo. This is the first export sale and the Indian Navy has apparently only received a few dozen of them. For India, Shyena replaces the Italian A244S, a 254 kilograms, 559 pounds, model widely used, by 16 nations, since the early 1980s model. These smaller torpedoes are used mainly for anti-submarine warfare and are usually fired from helicopters, naval patrol aircraft or warships. India bought 450 of the A244S but obtained a license to manufacture their version, called NST-58, in India and because of that was able to develop local suppliers for nearly all the components. Meanwhile, in 2011 India ordered 32 American MK-54 lightweight anti-submarine torpedoes to equip their 8 new P-8I anti-submarine aircraft. The existing P-3 aircraft, which the P-8 is replacing, usually carries 8 torpedoes. The MK-54 is, like Shyena, a 324mm, 12.75 inches, weapon, weighing about 340 kilograms, 750 pounds, and with a warhead containing 45 kilograms, 100 pounds, of explosives. Its guidance system has been designed to work well in shallow coastal waters. In addition, the U.S. Navy has 2 glide kits for air-launched anti-submarine torpedoes like the MK-54. Putting wings on torpedoes is all about U.S. Navy concern about the growing use of anti-aircraft missiles by submarines. To deal with that problem, it sought to equip some MK-54 torpedoes that are normally dropped into the water at a low altitude, by P-3 patrol aircraft, with an add-on glide kit. These systems consist of wings, control flaps, a flight control computer, battery and GPS for navigation. The kit allows a torpedo to be released at 6,300 meters, 20,000 feet, which is outside the range of submarine-launched anti-aircraft missiles, and glide, for 10 to 15 kilometers, down to about 100 meters, 300 feet, altitude, where the glide kit would be jettisoned, and the torpedo would enter the water and seek out the sub. Normally, the P-3 has to descend to under a 330 meters, 1,000 feet, to launch a MK-54 torpedo. This takes time and puts stress on the aircraft. Reducing stress on these larger maritime patrol aircraft was apparently one reason for introducing the glide kit. There are apparently not a lot of subs out there equipped with anti-aircraft missile systems. These systems have been around for years, and many are basically shoulder-fired type missiles adapted for launch from a waterproof container that is released by a submerged sub. The P-8s are jet-powered and prefer to remain at higher altitudes. There are other reasons for the glide kits. Many subs have sensors that are sensitive enough to detect low-flying helicopters, the main target for the sub's anti-aircraft missiles, and aircraft. The P-3 is also more effective if it can stay at high altitude all the time. Moreover, the glide kit is easy to build, since it can use items already used for smart bombs, JDAM, and earlier glide kits. The MK-54 lightweight torpedo entered production in 2003 and is a good example of how to handle development of systems like this. Costing about $1 million each, the MK-54 is a cheaper, and somewhat less capable replacement for the Cold War era high-tech MK-50 and the old reliable MK-46. The MK-54 is a more cost-effective alternative to the $3 million MK-50, which was in development for over two decades. The MK-50 was difficult to build because it was meant to be a smart torpedo that was light enough to be carried by helicopters and could go deep to kill Russian nuclear subs. But when the MK-50 finally became available in the late 90s, the typical target was a quieter diesel-electric sub in shallow coastal waters. So the MK-54 was developed, using cheaper, off-the-shelf, electronic components, some technology from the MK-50 and larger MK-48, as well as the simpler, but not deep-diving, frame and propulsion systems of the older MK-46 lightweight torpedo. Thus the 3.25-meter, 10-foot, long MK-54 is a bit of a hybrid, created to save money, and also be more capable against quieter subs operating in shallower water. The MK-54 has a range of about 10 km and a top speed of about 72 km an hour. It has a built-in sonar that can search for the target sub, as well as acoustic sensors, listening devices to pick up any sounds a sub might make. The MK-54 also has an onboard computer and a data file of underwater noises and search tactics, which are used as it tries to find its target, and keep it until it can hit the sub and destroy it with the explosives in the warhead. In the last 40 years, some 25,000 of the older MK-46 torpedoes were made, and at least a few thousand MK-54s have been manufactured. MK-50s are kept in inventory to deal with the few hostile nuclear subs that are still out there, although the MK-54 also has a capability of going deep, just not as deep as the more expensive MK-50. There is still a market for lightweight torpedoes that are produced in smaller quantities. A few thousand built and sold over a decade or so is economically viable. This was the case with the A244S and similar models from European nations. China also developed its own lightweight torpedo based on some A244S ones it bought. In addition to selling the torpedoes, the manufacturer makes a lot of money selling upgrades, customer modifications and maintenance and repair services. Most of these torpedoes are never used as intended and eventually retired when they are so old they are unreliable and not worth refurbishing. In light of all this, India will have a difficult time establishing Shyena as an economically and militarily worthwhile effort. Thanks for watching. I hope you like this news. Please share your views in comment box. Please like and share this video. Press subscribe button and bell for auto update to you regarding my channel World Action and Reaction News, WARN.